Good morning, Montfortians. Today we are going to start our next topic, that is types of concentration terms. As we have already done, concentration terms like molarity, molality, normality. So there are some concentration terms which are temperature dependent and some are which is temperature independent. As we all know, volume depends upon temperature. As we will increase or decrease the temperature, volume will also increase or decrease. But mass will never change according to temperature, whether we will increase it or whether we will decrease. So these are some concentration terms which depend upon volume. And these are temperature dependent. And these are some concentration terms which depend upon mass. And they are temperature independent. Now come to our next topic, that is Henry's law. Henry gave a relationship between solubility of gas in a liquid and pressure. Let us understand this statement with the example. Take a liquid containing container and the surface above the liquid, there are some gas particles. Now you want to mix these gas particles into this liquid. How you will mix it? By applying some pressure. As you will increase this pressure, solubility of these gas particles will also increase. As you will increase this pressure, solubility of these gas particles in this liquid will also increase. So according to this, Henry has given a statement that solubility of a gas in a liquid at constant temperature is directly proportional to the partial pressure of a gas. Solubility of a liquid in a gas at constant temperature is directly proportional to the partial pressure of a gas. What do you mean by partial pressure? Partial pressure means more than one gas. Like, take another container in which you have kept some liquid, and here are some air molecules like oxygen, nitrogen and hydrogen, and you want to mix only nitrogen molecules in this liquid. So the pressure exerted by only nitrogen molecules will be the partial pressure of a nitrogen gas. Okay, so after this, solubility was represented by mole fraction of gas in liquid. And after this statement, the statement given by Henry's was changed by Dalton, and he has given the another statement, that is partial pressure of a gas will always be equals to the mole fraction of gas in liquid. You can see Dalton has just replaced the solubility with the mole fraction. Now, according to maths, after removing this proportionality sign, a constant came, that is KH, and into X, that is mole fraction gas in liquid. Mole fraction of gas in liquid, and this KH is known as Henry's constant. Henry's constant. Now, the unit of KH will depend upon pressure. Why? Because mole fraction is unitless. So, whatever will be the unit of pressure, that will be the unit of KH, whether it is atm, whether it is bar, or etc. Now, I want to calculate the value of this mole fraction. How I will calculate? pressure upon Henry's constant will equals to the mole fraction of gas in liquid. As you can see, now Henry's constant is inversely proportional to the mole fraction, or mole fraction is inversely proportional to the Henry's constant. So if we will increase Henry's constant, value of mole fraction will decrease. If the mole fraction value will decrease, solubility will also be decrease. Value of Henry's constant depends upon the nature of gas and nature of solvent. Again, value of Henry's constant depends upon nature of a gas and nature of solvent. If we will increase the temperature, value of KH will also increase. If KH will increase, then solubility will decrease, or mole fraction will decrease. If mole fraction will decrease, solubility will also decrease. That is why aquatic animals feel more comfortable in cold water, because cold water temperature is less, then value of KH will also be less, then solubility or the mole fraction will be more. If mole fraction is more, then the solubility of oxygen in liquid will be more. So they can inhale maximum amount of oxygen and they can live safely. Now, all gases have a different value of KH. All gases have a different value of KH. Now come to the limitation of Henry's law. First limitation is pressure should be low, because at high pressure, the value of KH shows many deviation. Second, temperature should not be low. Again, at low temperature, the value of KH show maximum deviation. Third limitation, the gas should not be highly soluble. If maximum amount of gas will be soluble in water, and again the value of KH will not be accurate. Fourth, gas should not react chemically. Okay, so these are some limitations of Henry's law, which are very important. Next is applications of Henry's law. Henry's law is used in aerated drinks. It is used in scuba diving. It is used at high altitude. Okay, again, Henry's law used in aerated drinks, scuba diving, and at high altitude. Let us start with our next topic, that is vapor pressure. To understand vapor pressure, let us take another example. Take a liquid containing closed container. You will see after some time this liquid start converting into vapors, and this vapor will exert pressure on the container. When the liquid convert into vapor, it is known as evaporation. And after some time, these vapors start converting into liquid. This process is known as condensation. When the rate of evaporation becomes equal to the rate of condensation, evaporation becomes equal to condensation, that point is known as equilibrium. So, the definition of vapor pressure is the partial pressure exerted by the vapors at equilibrium is known as vapor pressure. Simple, the pressure exerted by the vapor at equilibrium is called vapor pressure. Now come to the factors affecting vapor pressures. The first factor affects vapor pressure is temperature. Simple, take a container, take a liquid containing container, start heating it. You will see as temperature will increase, more amount of liquid start converting into vapors. So vapor pressure will also increase. Okay, so as we will increase the temperature, vapor pressure will also increase. Second is nature of liquid. Nature of liquid. Again, take a container and fill it with liquid. Now, if this liquid is having a strong intermolecular force, is held together with a strong intermolecular force, then it will difficult to break. The bond will difficult to break. Then vapor pressure will decrease. If intermolecular force of attraction will be high, vapor pressure will be less. If intermolecular force of attraction will be less, then it will easily convert into vapors and vapor pressure will increase. Third is boiling point. If any liquid is having less boiling point, it will start boiling at less temperature. If it will start boiling at less temperature, then vapor pressure will be more of that liquid. If boiling point is high, then it will take more temperature to get heat up. So vapor pressure will be less. I hope you all have understood. So till now we have done Henry's law, vapor pressure, factors affecting vapor pressure. Which type of liquid exert vapor pressure? The answer is volatile liquid. What are volatile, or what do you mean by volatile? Volatile means anything that can be converted into vapors. If any liquid is converting into vapor, then it will exert pressure also. On these volatile substances, Raoult was the scientist who has done study. Many times in CBSE, this question was asked, what is the difference between Henry's law and Raoult's law? Henry's law stated that partial pressure of any gas is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that gas present in liquid. Present in liquid. And the almost same statement was given by Raoult. But what was the difference? Difference was that Raoult's statement was only applicable for volatile substances. Again, Raoult's statement was only applicable for volatile substances. So generally, the statement given by Raoult was that for any volatile substance, the partial pressure exerted by vapor or gas on the surface of liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in liquid. Again, for any volatile substance, the partial pressure exerted by vapor or gas on the surface of liquid is directly proportional to its mole fraction of a gas in liquid. To explain this statement, Raoult has done experiment in two cases, or in the form of two cases. In case one, Raoult has took volatile solute plus volatile solvent. And when you will mix volatile solute with volatile solvent, it will give you volatile solution. Before explaining, I want to say you that always the vapor pressure exerted by pure substance will be more than the solution. Vapor pressure exerted by pure substance will be more than the vapor pressure of solution. Understand? Case 1, take a volatile solute containing container. This is a volatile solute containing container. And let us give it a name A. Now, on the surface of this volatile solute, its particle only be there and some molecule will be present in the gaseous form also. And the pressure exerted by these gas molecule will be represented by PA naught. What is PA naught? PA naught is the vapor pressure exerted by the gases which is in purest form. Vapor pressure in pure form. Vapor pressure in pure form. Now take another container. Take another container and add solvent or volatile solvent in that. I am representing it with B. Let us show these particles with shade. Now, these particles are also present in the gas form. The pressure exerted by these particles will be PB naught. This is the vapor pressure of solvent in purest form. Vapor pressure of solvent in its pure form. Now add these two in the another container. That will be the solution. Now, on the surface of this, there will be the particles of solute also and solvent also. Solvent I am representing with the shaded. These are the particles of A and shaded one are the particles of B. Now, some solute particles are present in the gas form also and some solvent particles are also present in the gas form. In this, the pressure exerted by the solute particles, I am representing it with PA. What do you mean by PA? PA means the vapor pressure exerted by the gas particle when they are in the solution form. Now, vapor pressure exerted by the solvent molecule when they are present in the solution. Now, in total, if I'll ask you what is the total vapor pressure of this container or of the solution, it will be PA plus PB. Now, what is PA? PA, according to statement, for any volatile substance, the partial pressure exerted by vapor or gas on the surface of liquid is directly proportional to its mole fraction of gas in liquid. Mole fraction, it will be directly proportional of the mole fraction. And what is PB? PB will also be directly proportional to XB. Now, if I will remove this proportionality sign, what will come? Constant, and that constant I am representing it with PA naught into XA. PB is equals to PB naught XB. Now, what is PT or total pressure? Total pressure was PA plus PB. What is PA? PA is PA naught XA, PB is PB naught XB. Now you know XA plus XB is equals to 1. To solve this equation, we have to take one condition. That is, let us imagine PA naught is greater than PB naught. The vapor pressure of PA is greater than PB naught. If PA is greater than PB naught, then whose value we will calculate from this? That is XB 1 minus XA. Now put in this equation, PA naught XA plus PB naught 1 minus XA. Now PA naught XA plus PB naught minus PB naught XA. After this, what will come? PB naught, we will take common XA and then PA naught minus PB naught. PB naught XA we will take out common and it will be PA naught minus PB naught. So at last PT is equals to PB naught plus XA PA naught minus PB naught. Okay, we can take PB naught is greater than PA naught. We can take anything. If PB naught is greater than PA naught, then according to XA plus XB is equals to 1, whose value we will put? XA, that will be equals to 1 minus XB. So as we know, PT was equals to PA naught XA plus PB naught XB. In this, whose value we will put? XA, PA naught 1 minus XB plus PB naught XB. Now PA naught minus PA naught XB plus PB naught XB. Now PT is equals to PA naught. From this we will take out XB common, then it will be equals to PA minus PB naught. Okay. Now take minus common from this, then it will be PT equals to PA naught plus XB PB naught minus PA naught. So this is the equation when PB naught was greater than PA naught, and this was the equation when PA naught was greater than PB naught. Now take this equation 1, take this equation 2 and this equation 3. If you will see these equations first, second, then you can see that these are the line equations which is passing from origin. Like what is the equation of line? That is y equals to mx that passes from the origin. Okay. If I will compare this equation with PA is equals to PA naught XA, then y is equals to PA, m is equals to PA naught and x is equals to XA. Similarly, we can compare second equation with this. Second equation was PB equals to PB naught XB. What is y now? PB. What is m? PB naught. And what is x? XB. And the last Pt was equals to Pb naught plus XA Pa naught minus Pb naught. We will compare this equation with Y equals to Mx plus C. In this case, Y is Pt, M is Pa naught minus Pb naught, X is XA and C is Pb naught. Okay, now we will draw a graph with the help of these equations. That is, first we will draw for equation number 1. Equation number 1 was this, in which on y-axis we will write Pa and on x-axis we will write XA. Now, as you all know, the value of mole fraction is varies from 0 to 1. So, I am taking the lowest value of XA is 0 and the highest value of XA is 1. Okay. Now, we all know PA is equals to PA naught XA. If XA is 0, then PA is also be 0. So, what is the value of PA? PA is 0. I can represent here. If XA is 1, then the value of PA will be equals to PA naught. So, let us take anywhere this PA naught will be somewhere like here I can take. Okay, now join it. Give it a name PA naught. Okay, now join this point with this also. This is the graph for PA is equals to PA naught XA for this equation. Now, in the same graph, we can draw the graph for second equation, that is PB is equals to PB naught XB. Okay. Now, on the y-axis, we have to show PB. On the x-axis, we have to show XB and M is PB naught. Okay. So, y-axis is this. Now, here I am showing PB. I can show. Now, on the x-axis, XB. If here XA is 1, then what will be the XB? XB is 0. If XA is 0, then here XB will be 1. Okay. If XB is equals to 0, then PB will be 0. If XB is 1, then PB will equals to PB naught. So, let us take here XB is 0 on this point. So, PB will also be 0. Where XB is 1, then PB is equals to PB naught. XB is 1, then PB is equals to PB naught. Let us mark here PB naught. Now, you can see this point is down and this point is up. Why? Because I am drawing for the condition PA naught is greater than PB naught. Now, join these two point and this also. This is the graph for PB is equals to PB naught XB. Now, this line is showing PT, total pressure, that is PA plus PB. I hope you all have understood. If you have understood, please draw the graph for PB naught is greater than PA naught. Now come to case 2. Case 2. In case 2, Raoult has took non-volatile solute plus volatile solvent. And when you will mix non-volatile with volatile, it will give you non-volatile solution. Non-volatile means which cannot evaporate. Okay. So for this, again take a container containing volatile solvent. Solvent which I am representing with A. And on the surface of it, only A particles will be there, and some will be present in the gaseous form also because it is volatile. Now the pressure exerted by these vapor or these gas particles will be PA naught because it is in pure form. Now take another container containing non-volatile solute. I am representing it with shaded solute and give it a name B. Now as you know, it is non-volatile, so it will not be in the gaseous form. Now take a third container and mix these two. After mixing, it will form a non-volatile solution. And on the surface of this, there will be the particles of solvent also and solute also, in which solvent is volatile and solute is non-volatile. This is volatile solvent. These are the particles of non-volatile solute. So in this, only the gas particle of solvent will be there, and we will represent with PA. PA is the vapor pressure exerted by the solvent when it is in a solution form. Okay, and you know the vapor pressure exerted by the substance in its pure state is always greater than the vapor pressure exerted by the substance in the solution form. Now, what is PA? According to definition, PA is directly proportional to XA. After removing the sign of proportionality, what will come? PA naught XA. Now you can see from here to here, vapor pressure has been decreased. From here to here, vapor pressure has been decreased. And this statement is known as relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure, which is a colligative property, which we will discuss further. Now, we want to calculate change in pressure, that is delta P. Change in pressure, that is delta P. What is delta P? Delta P is PA naught minus PA. Now what is PA? PA is PA naught minus XA. Take common PA naught. What will come? 1 minus XA. Now we know XA plus XB is equals to 1. Then 1 minus XA is equals to XB. Okay, so delta P is equals to PA naught into XB. Delta P upon PA naught, PA naught is equals to XB. This ratio is known as relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. We can write it as PA naught minus PA upon PA naught. is equals to xb. This is also relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now, as we all know, what is mole fraction? What is mole fraction? Mole fraction is number of moles of that component upon total number of moles. Okay. So, number of moles of B upon total number of moles, that is Na plus Nb. Let Na is much more bigger than Nb. So, we can neglect Nb and we can write this statement as delta P upon Pa naught is equals to Nb upon Na. Okay, Nb upon Na. Now, delta P upon Pa naught is equals to Nb upon Na. Now, what is Nb? Number of moles. Number of moles will be weight of B upon molar mass of B. Okay. And this Na, what it will be? Ma upon Wa. This statement I can write it as relative lowering of vapor pressure. And it will be equals to Wb upon Mb into MaWa. From here you can calculate the molecular mass of B. I hope you all have understood. That's all for today. Have a nice day ahead.